This project was to provide non-permanent type anchors for the car canopy, raise it further off of the ground to fit our RV, and at the same time provide some shock absorbing so that it could handle wind gusts better. First off, I cut 10-foot, 3/4-inch, schedule 40 PVC pipe into 4 pieces. So they were 2.5 feet long, probably longer than needed. But since the pipes were 10-foot, I started that way and figured I could cut them off. Just for neatness sake, sanded off the rough edges from cutting. Then I drilled holes just a few inches from the bottom and drove a screw through them to help them from sliding inside the concrete. I mixed up some concrete in normal fashion, just enough to work with a few bricks at a time. Then I took 8x8 cinder blocks, placed one of the pipes in it so that you didn't push the pipe down into the concrete and fill the pipe up with concrete. That's in order to provide a drain system for the pipe in case it gets water in at the top. In this case, I chose to fill the brick half, maybe two-thirds, because I'm planning on putting a domed cap on it in order to make it a little bit more than 8 inches. You probably can straighten the pipe right to begin with, but if you wait a few minutes for it to set up, it'll be a little firmer. And then you can use one of several different ways of making sure that it's straight up and down. Now, after it's cured, this was a day later, I tipped them over, and you can see where the pipe was touching the bottom, but it would have some concrete in it. I poked that concrete out of the bottom edge of the pipe so that any water entering the top would have a way to drain out the bottom and not fill it up. Then I mixed up some more concrete, this time making it about as heavy as I dared, because I'm going to be forming a cap. I didn't want it to settle and flow out over the edges. Shoveling it instead of pouring it because it's mixed heavy enough. Then I took an eye bolt with a nut on the bottom, shoved it into the wet cement before finishing off the concrete. Then finished off a domed top so that when the canopy legs go down over it, they're held maybe 1.5 to 2 inches up further than the 8-inch concrete block. Then I'll let them cure. After the concrete is set up, I placed the pipes for the legs of the canopy over the pipes in the concrete blocks, and then hooked up my bungee cord for a shock system. This way, gusts of wind can be absorbed slightly and make it last a little bit better. And now it's tall enough to drive under in our road trek Class B RV.